And I am going to be a junior this coming year, and I've been involved in CSC since freshman year, and I was not always as involved as I am now. I definitely have been privileged. I think of it as a privilege to actually experience spiritual poverty. Actually be in the trenches and understand what it is that the students across the way at Florida State have experienced, because as much as God is so present here, it can be very easy to live in a bubble and very easy to just like stay in comfort, you know. But God was so gracious enough, as hard as it was, to allow me to even go through the suffering of spiritual poverty. And then through his mercy, he pulled me out. But I guess I can just speak to that a little bit. So I came to Florida State over summer, and summer C specifically is when the freshmen come. So they're very excited and very eager to be away from home, away from mom and dad, and to be honest, just to be ready to go out and have a good time. And a lot of the times that includes underage drinking and promiscuity and all these things that the college experience, unfortunately, that our society pertains it to be. So I went through a hard time where I did feel very peer pressured to partake in the side of the underage drinking. And it was hard because during that time I felt very unwelcome to be myself, very like rejected to be Isabelle. Like, absolutely do not be Isabelle, because your friends will just reject you. So instead, I'd go to these parties and be someone who I'm not. But the entire time, the Holy Spirit was like just nudging in my heart, and I knew that God wanted me to be somewhere different. And I felt the hole and the darkness of spiritual poverty. It was real, and it was painful, and it was something that, and I get emotional because, like, I get really passionate about it, because I don't want anyone to experience that pain, especially at the young age of 18, coming into college. It's so real, like, it's very painful and lonely, but in God's mercy, He can bring us out, and He did that for me. Praise the Lord. He introduced CSU to me, and he introduced the brothers, and Brother Jason, being his outgoing and joyful self, he introduced me to all the staff, and I started going to daily mass, and I cannot even put human words to the value that receiving Jesus's heart into your heart every day, how much that affects the way you live. I cut off the bad friendships. I began to talk to the Lord instead, and He put really healthy, good friendships in my life. He put missionaries in my life. The interns who are here at CSU, they taught me what it means to be a missionary. And even if I don't have the chance to go out on mission, they taught me what it means to have a missionary spirituality, again, at, like, right across the street at Florida State. It hurts because I still see the pain in some of the girls in the young men's eyes, I recognize it, and I recognize in the pain that they're masking. Everyone becomes such a master at masking the pain. But if someone could just see a college student's heart who is lonely, who is alone, who doesn't have anyone to even share joys with, not just sorrows, it would be a very sad heart. And that's not what God wants for his children. He wants fullness of joy. And if we have an opportunity to somehow reach to not just Florida State, but any college campus, that would change the church. It would change the world, and it would change the way that we love people. It would bring a peace that is simply from the Holy Spirit. And I have found this peace, even to the point of where I am discerning religious life. And that is a peace that I only thank Jesus for, because I know how much he loves me. I know how much he doesn't want me to be in spiritual poverty. And I hope that somehow through Catholic World Missions, we can bring back the peace and the joy. And I want to see, I wish I could see the light. Like, I want to share this light that I have, that God has been so merciful to give me, with my brothers and sisters who are in spiritual poverty, and in the depths and in the trenches. So I just pray that God's will be done, and that the Holy Spirit will be active, and we have faith in him, and he will never be